Hi and welcome to this video on the Milner-Barry Gambit, the French Advanced Variation. The reason I'm making this video is because I played an interesting 15 plus 15 minute game against a top 10 rated player on Lichess in a Lichess Classical. And I thought, okay, I wanted to learn something from this opening. I was playing black and this game started with the e4. e6, d4, d5, e5, the French advance variation, c5, c3, protecting the pawn, knight of c6, attacking the pawn on d4, and now knight of f3, protecting it. And here I played queen b6, which is both attacking this pawn and also indirectly, and also putting pressure on b2. Other options would be to play bishop to d7, the Uwe variation, or you could also take on d4. but I like this move, queen b6, since it's putting pressure on white immediately. Now, white plays bishop to d3, and you can see here that this is going into this gambit line where you don't protect this pawn because the bishop is blocking the queens at the moment. So so you're ready to give up this pawn. In compensation, you get a quick development, and this bishop is pointing into black's kingside, so we want maybe to look out for attack that start with knight to g5 and queen into the position, and this bishop can also join in, so it could quickly be dangerous for black if you don't look out for this. But I still think it's good, good variation for black, if you know what you're doing. And here I took on d4, and after exchange, you'll notice that you can't take directly with the knight takes here, because after white captures and you take back with the queen, now there's a check here, and the black queen is immediately in trouble. So here you can see now black is lost. So therefore you want to play bishop to d7, protecting this check and reinforcing the threat on the d4 pawn. And after I played this move, my opponent castled. And here now you can see here I have two attackers on this pawn and only one defender. So now I took it, and here you have it, the Milner-Barry Gambit. The pawn has been gambited, and now white has to show that he has compensation for this pawn. And my opponent played knight to d2. It's another variation goes knight takes d4, queen takes d4, knight c3, and here black can choose to play a6, stopping any jumps with the knight, and also maybe preparing a move like b4 in the future. And here white can protect the pawn with the queen to e2, and black plays rook to c8, and that's really I think it's really a pleasant position for black. And the results from the database also shows that black has good results in this position. Another choice would be to play bishop to e3, but as you might see, this pawn here is now unprotected, and that can black can exploit by taking here the check. And now you can see here that you can pick up the pawn on b2. So bishop e3 is not advised for white. But my opponent played knight to d2, and here I simply played my my knight back to c6. I considered taking here, but I couldn't really see what it helped me, how this exchange helped, since I actually think that the knight here back on c6 does a good job putting pressure on the white pawn on e5. My opponent played knight to b3, and here I played knight to g to e7, trying to get it into the game here on g3. And here my opponent developed his bishop, and you can see here now this pawn is no longer unprotected due to the knight. And here I have two choices: either to play queen back to c7 or to d8. I think the downside of playing queen to c7 is that white wants to put his rook on this file. On upside, you put extra pressure on this pawn on c7. But I actually think that queen to d8 is a reasonably good move. But in the database, there's 17 games with queen to c7 and only one with a queen to d8. In that game, black player was Alexander Morozovich. And in a game against Veselin Topalov, and he and Morozovich actually got a really pleasant position out of the opening of the game. So I can be a little bit proud that I played the move that Morozovich played against Topalov. And here, Topalov actually also played knight c8, and I deviated from that game by playing knight to g6, and I thought I can give this pawn up and play queen over here and put pressure on this pawn, and it's actually not that bad. But Morozov played in his game rook to b8, protecting the pawn, and Topalov played rook to c1, and here he played knight to g6, and now you can see that there's pressure on this pawn, and yeah, Morozovich could easily have won this game, but it was a blitz game, so and he messed it up later in the game. Unfortunately, but here after knight g6, my opponent took. I played queen to b8, and here my opponent took on g6, and I made a mistake by taking here on b7. The best would have been to take here, since after the move and knight to c5, which I thought was the strongest, black can actually play knight takes e5, because there's a threat here on the h file. So after this, you can see here now it mate is threatened. So actually, after h takes g6, the best is to play knight to d6. Here black can take, and here black has a good position, I think. I think I will stop the game here at this point where I made a mistake, and I went on to lose the game, but I think it was interesting to look at this opening line, and I hope you got something out of it too. And if you want to look at the double of Morozovic game, I'll put a link down in the description. And please, if you like this video, and please give me a subscribe, and leave a comment if you have any questions. Bye.